Hey guys, I'm KDH here, and we're doing another run of Boss Battles Normal in Kid Icarus Uprising with another weapon type with weaker than base stats and no powers used. And this time, the weapon type is Capricorn Club, and the handicap modifier is shot range -3, which reduces the projectile range of all projectiles by 40%. And yeah, that's actually a deserved nerf to Capricorn Club's neutral shot, which, believe me, it's blown shot, as we're going to see right about now. Now, the one thing that does keep shot range -3 in general relevant is the max range damage multiplier. Capricorn Club has a max range damage multiplier of 22%. There will be some scenarios where we'll be more than 30 meters away than our target in the first place. But even with this, neutral shot is still blown short. See what I mean? I think we were consistently close to Twinville at that time. I'll have more to talk about with that particular aspect, but for now, we do have a boss where we start off very far from Dark Lord Gal. Because why not? Vignes is coming up. Oh my goodness, they... Gunner wanted to be annoying there and dispersed. I thought I missed all. Go! And yeah, you can float shot the neutral shot. The big thing is that Capricorn Club has a shorter charge of time than any other club except Magnus, which speaks for itself with its own short range. Yeah, this is particularly going to play a role here. More or less. Especially since the energy orbs don't even have any HP. Stop Capricorn Club from just shutting them down. Hey look, 3 damage. Yeah, you do the fireball attack, buddy. And you're dead now. Wait, you're still alive? Well, not for long. Bye, Yuja. Next up is Great Reaper. And there is another aspect to cover about the Capricorn Club. Capricorn Club's neutral shot, although one sub here. worry about that later, because plots do not have anything. Any mobility to speak of, and Capricorn Club is barely any faster than Skyscraper or Earth Mall. And Capricorn Club also doesn't even get its walking speed boosted when doing the neutral swing. With Skyscraper Club, at least it does get, even if it's a 10% bonus, which only does so much. And I mean, there are moments when the neutral swing is still helpful. Laughing about blowing up a bomb on herself. And I think this can actually kill Pandora as well. Certainly contribute to the... Or certainly set off the end of her first phase. Convenient well! Huh? Ah. Thanks, Dogfit. I really wanted to... Yeah, Pandora was basically dead at that point. Okay. So that takes care of that. Anyway, you might have noticed that, like I say, the Capricorn Club neutral shot has slipshot property. And that's what gets it flip-charted on multiplayer. Which... You might be wondering why King Halo Club doesn't have this same involvement of float shot. Well, Halo Club's own shot are also floor. Bye, Dogfit! Anyway, as I was saying, Halo Club's neutral shot is actually overall slower. It does get faster than Capricorn Club's neutral shot, but too late to be anything dramatic. Especially since I think Halo Club's neutral shot is loud enough to begin with. Thank you for the hit stop. Now, you might know that the forward shot, the neutral shot, does destroy the magic health cap part at 12 points. But the forward shot doesn't? Okay! Yeah, pretty positive with the IMAX range damage multiplier and its influence here. And that's going to be relevant because, well, I'll get into that. Swing. that take that care of that. Oh yeah, the yard. Bye, Thanatos! The urn might have been a threat, but because of the skulls, because we don't have good mobility with Capricorn Claw, but overall, Thanatos is not too bad to deal with. Really, being able to deal with David at all. That's what happened with the... The neutral suit. Yeah, case in point! And I think that was a max range hit as well. So. Seriously, it's the neutral suit that, that deserves the nerfing the most. Why? That would have hit it. That would hit without short range minus. Because seriously, that's the big thing about the Capricorn Club's base ring for the neutral switch. Why does it outrange every blade, a claw, and palm other than optical blade in when it comes to neutral switch? Much with 90% club melee drink, but averting punishment for close range whatsoever, being up close whatsoever, is still helpful just to get around the max range damage multiplier. And look at this! Heck, we have a fight where the short range minus is actually going to have needless effect. Sort of Peloton. And that didn't even reach it. I know that was a close one of those pesky dwarfs. Hey, we have to deal with full attack scenarios. I'm just aiming at Matthews' dress. Good luck hitting Matthews with this thing. At a decent frequency, I mean. And undoubtedly we'll get Sid flying back to the park. I think the damage against Matthews when we hit her in the face is limited. I mean, the usual 10% bonus that I should mention that mooks actually do take double damage when hit in weak spots. At least sometimes, but there's no token effort to have And bosses take more damage when hit in their weak spots, unless it's suddenly later. Case it like a sudden later boss. But give it in three bosses for now. No, actually two. Okay, game! Okay, so that takes care of that phase. Now for the second phase. Okay, Matt is gonna use the poison hand attack. Uh-oh, come on. Or does the phase can end immediately? I can work with that. Okay, you won the cluster me, Matt Pusa. Excuse me, Matt Pusa! Never get dead. Die, Matt Pusa! I'll tell you! Even forget who fed you! You stupid Matt Pusa! And here's a boss who will be less annoying than he was when we were using Magnus Club. I mean, granted, all the annoyance will be gone, but... at least we can hit him in the face without ridiculous amounts of beating. Of course, beating does still help. Ah, I can parry dozen times! Clubs, you and your 90-year delay. That tornado attack would be far worse than 9.0. Useless berry charge up. Okay, I'm glad that Phoenix did not cheat with the fire for little hitboxes. You're grounded, Phoenix! Hey, it's Crackalinch! And yeah, Dragonlance was the boss I was talking about, who doesn't have only an attention. Damage bonus on hitting his weak body. He takes, I believe, 30% if you don't hit him on the weak spot. Yeah, 30%. So, yeah, you deal over 3 times as much damage hitting him in the weak spot as if you hit him in a regular body. Dang it. I keep missing the weak spot. That's annoying. And bye-bye, Dragonlance. I was worried that I was going to get hit, but... anyway, reset bomb pod. It could actually be trouble with the shot range minus mod. Okay, I know that guy's melee, so he's not going to trouble me for a while. You give me that parry charge up for once! You give me that parry charge up. Could have gone for another hit there, but no, I did just a... Yeah, the max range damage multiplier is making the damage infliction against the cards actually problematic. You whip me around the way. And reset bomb pod is down. I don't even have to worry about the next two bosses of Capricorn Club. One of them is Arlan. By the way, I think Capricorn Club is... I want to say Capricorn Club is model blow type. I forget. Trap halo. I should mention that Capricorn Club has 4 shot cancel. But But then again, the shots are powerful enough. Especially at close range, so they can at least cancel. They do at least have decent canceling ability on the entire shot cancel attack, which will come into play here. Yeah, Arlon's the definition of squishy wither. The thing with Dick wife was? Why didn't a boat watch that? Okay. Well, I wasn't trapped there. No damage against Phosphora, yeah. Yeah, neutral shot just eats her alive, pretty much. And now for this thing. Aurum Core. Demonstrate one particular thing. Well, first I'm getting rid of the turret because Okay, so I can't hit the core from all the way from the perimeter. But I do come close enough. I believe there was some homing involved there. Oh yeah, that's another thing to talk about. Capricorn Club has homing on it sucks. Not a whole lot, but especially for the speed. Game being cheeky with me. Yeah, Capricorn Club is still good against Aurum Core. You do still have to consider positioning more with shot range plus, but with shot range minus. But without shot range minus, you could actually snipe Aurum Core from the perimeter, quite frankly. Right. And it's not like the damage, it's a choke. So, yeah. I think that would have hit. Cheap shot arm generator of RNG idiocy. Excuse me. I've got you electrifying the left rail. You bet. try and find just one more. But at least Magnus Club, at least Capricorn Club can actually hit the Orm Generator from the center of Bell's path. I mean, granted, the damage isn't impressive, but at least... off of being able to hit the flapped and forged Sun Cancel attacks. I should mention that Capricorn Club, like Magnus Club, that's lower shot canceled than most other clubs. Oh my goodness. But I wouldn't give for this thing to actually die. There we go. Not the crisis mode life. Arm generator of RNG idiocy likes to be cheap at times.
Thanks.
As we see it. And Capricorn Club still has better range than Magnus. I think it has the same shot cancel values. Or I think it's all of its shots are 4 shot cancel. Whatever. Got sucker punched by the fireball. Now for Arm Pyron's second phase. Thankfully, we can hit Arm Pyron from a safer distance. Which especially helps with the blasted mines attack. I should mention that you can actually destroy the mines with club swings. Like so. And I would too focus on the mine. I sorry, they should be less durable in general. But you can destroy them with more attack. I mean, why did they have that 4 shot cancel to begin with? But yeah, you can destroy the mines with the neutral swing. And I believe even Skyscraper Club has better swing walking than Capricorn Club does. So Capricorn Club can do it, then there's no reason any other club can. Takes care of Arm Pyron. Yeah, little else was worth mentioning that fight. Faircloth! Wait a minute, did that nothing to do with Capricorn Club? And everything to do with a fight that gets the little better balance. Well, you have no weapon type, no powers. Nothing. You're just stuck with a guy with not even a projectile. I mean, sorry, he has thumb base damage. You'd expect that from Ogre Club. And at that point, I would feel that Magnus would deserve some speed stats going on. Right. Chariot Cheer! We gotta deal with him. And mercifully, he did not cheat with the mines. It's a sucker punch, desperate one. I think game. How did I miss there? Chariot Cheater, everybody. His fireballs are particularly obnoxious. He can actually start with the mind, and they're so nightmarish to dodge. What were the developers thinking with that? Game! I wanted to parry down to the side, not backwards against the homing attack. I would kneel before you, Valentina, but you're a little too possessed for me to want to do that. No thanks.
Cover your eyes.
You're bad. I think submarines might have decided to take it. But then again, why does the neutral shot have to be a multi-worthy thing in multiplayer? He's not behaving. And you invited an archer. Isn't that fun?
This might
help. You never know. I think I was about to get hit by the archer there. Now to kill Chaos King again. And yeah, doesn't make sense because we already killed the Chaos King. Yay! I love being in. Kind of got unexpectedly. And Dark Pit, have you not heard of Blinky? Gosh. Maybe we can hit King of Kin from far away. There's another thing that helps. Only problem is, Stop Range Minus being a thing. And there's some range minus, making my max range damage multiplier kick in. But yeah, homing is capable of being useful in this time. So for some reason, the forward and side shots have higher homing delay than the neutral shot. Why? Hindsight, gotta be hindsight, I suppose. Away with you, Chaos Kid! Pandora shouldn't be too bad. Get up, you pet! There you are. And at the end of Amazon Pandora. I'm taking a drink. I'd be happy if I can get past this fight without any health lost in the first place, but Hades' heart likes to be erratic. I can't believe I got through that. Clear on the float. Sorry for sitting at the float. I decided to aim at the big so that I wouldn't hit the real thing and unintentionally set up a berserk mode when I don't want it. Anytime who likes to be uncooperative at the best of times. Come on, Enoch, where are you? It doesn't help that with the maximum 30 meter range. Oh, you passed me. I got caught up! God, by the gun! Tell Lady Thor to go home because he is home. In and out. Man, I'm afraid of this. Max and Shannon, multiplier, everybody. I can't tell where Hades Heart is again. How did I get there? As long as he's not spawning big on top of me. Found. Nice thing I hit the bait there. And there we go. Hades Heart is down. Without too much damage taken. Just that bomb explosion knocked off. And caught me off guard because I was expecting to parry dodge, but. Away with you, Magnus! At least Capricorn Club can't cheat that, unlike Magnus Club can. bring up that Ale Club's primary advantage over... Over Capricorn Club is a better backup utility. You what, gal? Well, that knockback is being... just being bad. Okay, good. They're both down. I may actually be able to get this into drinks if I don't do too terribly against Pseudo-Palutena. Of course, knowing Capricorn Club's melee drink issues. Ah, dang it! Apparently I wanted the club, the melee combo, not the... You die already, you big pig. At least I'm beautiful. Watch, this drink is going to be redundant. But I'm taking it because I... messed up against the big pig. And this fight is basically... so this is what it feels to have some range. I got clipped by one of the shockwaves there. And by one of the creep shots, and by one of the arrows. That great secret treasure in the turn straight page because he's using it as the more sophisticated attack. Okay. Both are neutral shots. Because seriously, convenient tornado destruction there. And that's all she wrote. I think I was still above half health there. You Yeah, yeah, Capricorn Club has, so yeah, something over Magnet Club. It, yeah, neutral soft load start, everybody. It's worth about 10 at it. Capricorn Club is comparable to Halo Club, except with the back shots, but as far as the neutral forward and side shots go, Capricorn Club has better velocity. It's stronger at lower ranges, which is all that really matters with shot range plus. So, the lower range absolutely fits it. It actually should have lower range because the idle description says it has low range. I mean, it is low as far as clubs go, but neutral shot, Capricorn has a higher range with its neutral shot than any blade other than optical, any claw, or any palm does with their neutral shot. How did that work? A remaster could stand to make rebounces like this, I swear to Palutena.